Is Veterans Day, and in honor of Veterans Day, we need to talk about all the special things that are going on. By the way, if you're a veteran and you're planning on going out to eat somewhere, when you go into a restaurant, check and see whether or not they have anything special going on, because there's a lot of restaurants doing very special things.
Yeah, some incredible things going on, but we are honored to have Brian O'Keefe, Des Moines firefighter, here with us this morning. But many people might not realize you're also a veteran.
Yeah, today here my capacity is as a veteran, and I want to reach out to my fellow veterans. It's a special day for me and for them and their families because of the sacrifices they've made. So today's something I always take the day off, get out there, you know, visit with gentlemen, men and women that, you know, they don't get out and talk about what they've done and what they've been through. So it's a neat experience today.
Right. Now, today is the day that we honor the veterans. They're out there. Now, this was the anniversary of the ending of one of the World Wars.
Yes.
On this date, and then it was adopted, and then name was changed a few years later to what we now know as Veterans Day.
Correct.
Now, you just got back from being deployed.
Yep, I got back home early Saturday morning from a deployment to northern Afghanistan.
Wow.
Made a couple trips over there.
I know you a little bit, and you're gone a lot. You've been deployed a lot. And so thank you for your service, and I know it's probably nice to be home for you.
Sure, it's an exciting time, but again, without the support of your friends and family and your employer, you know, to get away and know that things are stable and going well at home. I see too much, you know, being deployed where people are struggling with what's going on at home and they can't focus on their mission. So that's
so what was your mission when you were over there?
I do a medium altitude reconnaissance surveillance platform, so we're kind of like the blimp over the Super Bowl. You know, we're the eyes and ears, where we see the stuff that was supposed to happen, stuff that's going to happen, and so we're really valuable, timely information.
Wow.
For the troops on the ground and the commanders making big decisions.
I didn't realize it was that cool. So you're airman then?
No, I'm. No. I've been in the Army. You know, I did helicopters for 19 years, and I've been in a plane. I just went over 33 years, so I've been around a little bit.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, what did you bring with you today?
Well, this is, you know, I'm as an American, everyone loves their flag, so this is something, you know, that soldiers do. But I've had this with me since 2002. Made several trips into Iraq, been to Afghanistan, Egypt, South America. So a flag is just something you tuck away with you and remind you of home and what you're fighting for.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm always grateful. A lot of people, you know, they try to stay connected with their soldiers that are deployed. So I had a pillowcase that a church group sent, and I have there is a group of kids that one of their school projects was just a little hat to keep you warm. But, you know, I wore it, and I, you know, I try to reach out. I, you know, send them an email, let them know where I'm at, what I'm doing, get the appreciation they deserve for recognizing us over there, and
right.
Reminds us
of home.
We
always hear about organizations, you know, sending over care packages and things like that. It's nice to know that they do reach our soldiers and that you guys are utilizing them and kind of hanging on to pieces of home.
I had to wait till the end because, you know, I grabbed this in July over there. I didn't really need it.
But need
I was watching some early morning football, baseball just last month in Afghanistan, and it finally cooled off where I put it on at 4 in the morning, keep my ears warm while I was watching.
Now, it does make a difference when people receive things from back home, doesn't it?
It is very touching. You know, it's a grind over there. Same people, same faces. You didn't forget. I mean, I was smiling on the plane flying home because I had a woman holding the child that was crying. Everyone else is doing this. I don't see kids. I don't
right.
see
Aww.
Pets, animals, the routine stuff that you take for granted here. But I even was cracking up driving in my first morning traffic this morning because I normally over there I flew, so I was high altitude.
Yeah.
And on the base I had a bicycle that I was
cool.
As Jason can attest, if I'm on my bike, I don't, you know, I'm happy wherever I'm
right.
going.
Yeah, right.
So
all that goes.
And what's the map there?
Well, this is a road map of Afghanistan. Fortunately, in my position, you know, I've traveled throughout the country. A lot of people, they land at a base and they never get outside the wire. And so this is just a reminder for myself, and I share that with others as to, you know, how big a place it is and how diverse the country is and the people that live there and the challenges that
so
we're still facing.
So how big of an area were you overseeing?
The northern half of Afghanistan.
Which is about how big? Put it in perspective.
Because
we hear about Afghanistan all the time. How big is it? How big of an area are we talking here?
Well, just my area, I was doing, I don't know, in square miles, but, you know, I'd go 100 miles in all directions from, mm-hmm. I was 93 miles from the Pakistan border, which I couldn't go 94 because otherwise I'd be in their country, which they didn't like me flying
wow.
over there too close. So you went right up to the border and that was it. But, So wherever the...
So basically from Des Moines to Iowa City, that general amount
right.
of distance.
But you got to imagine there's 18,000-foot mountains in there and
sure.
Friendlies and enemies. And I mean, we got ISIL, Taliban, ANA. So it was just not as many U.S. soldiers out there doing stuff like I... Because I did the same mission in 2013.
Mm-hmm.
So it's you see
fewer
the change.
Now, yeah.
Absolutely.
How many
yeah.
times have you been deployed?
Six.
Six
yeah.
different times. You going back?
No, not we never talk about that from my wife. That's the last one. Oh, that was the last one. So that's kind of the unwritten joke.
But
never
as
again.
You said, today is about sharing stories with your fellow veterans as well. So you kind of carry these things around so you can have things to talk about and your experiences.
Yeah, I'm a softy, as you know, but I, you know, having something like this, and I'm an old Huey pilot, so I can always talk to Vietnam vets about a Huey back in the day. But I have a friend. Bradley, I won't say his last name, but I'm meeting him here in a couple hours. Young, mid-30s, wife, kids, you know, compressed vertebrae. You know, so there's guys out there that, you know, might not have taken a bullet, but they're still suffering for their country because of the sacrifices they made. So, you know, I'm hoping to catch him to get down to Hy-Vee Hall for the Veterans Event at 11. But
and a lot of those injuries you can't see.
Yeah,
in a lot of cases.
Exactly.
And I think we all need to remember that.
Yeah, and I was over there trying to make contact with a soldier that, you know, has basically on Facebook said, you know, I give up, man. I'm wore up, beat up, and to see those younger soldiers that, you know, faced and done things, you know, much harder than I ever have. Today I want to, you know, think about those, reach out to them, but yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing Bradley. I saw him in 2010 after him and his group were blown up by an IDF. He came walking out of the hospital, you know, just wearing a PT uniform because they strip you down, and he just couldn't take the screaming and yelling of his fellow buddies from his squad. And all of a sudden I said, where are you from? And he said, Iowa. And I said, where in Iowa? And it turns out we had mutual friends and we stayed in touch for years. So yeah, there's a lot of veterans out there that have given a lot that today I'd like to remind everyone of that.
Great story.
Good for you. So let's talk about a couple of events that are happening today. If people want to get out and salute our troops, maybe go shake some hands and say some hi to people, or opportunities for veterans as well. So we have a couple graphics we want to throw up there. If you're a veteran, you can sign up to win a free stay at the Hotel Patee. Go check out their Facebook page for that. So, you know, who doesn't love a great stay for all the service that you've done? Other great events going on. This is a pretty big one. You can check out things to do on the Des Moines Register page. They have quite a few events.
Exactly.
Posted there, and you're talking about one
this
over
is,
at
this
Hy-Vee
is my Hall. Favorite. I make this annually. Took James Reed, 97-year-old vet, 3 years ago to it, and it was awesome because you sing your branches song, and they all stand up, and it's neat to see these old veterans get up and still straighten their backs.
Straighten their backs a little bit there for you. And we also want to remind you of an event that's happening tomorrow at Des Moines North High School, 4th Annual Veterans Day Assembly. That's going to be in the morning, and that is tomorrow. So events happening today and tomorrow people can definitely take advantage of. And like you said, you enjoy just going to Hy-Vees and going saying hi to some veterans.
Exactly.
Visiting with people, yeah.
You bet.
Thank you again, man, for your
Thanks,
Brian.
For everything.
Thank
Thanks
you
for coming.
Look forward to seeing you again soon when I get back in the fire department.
Okay, no. What is that from again?
That is from, they call it Hammer, an AC-130 gunship, and they also have Apache gunships. So.
Can I see that for a second?
Absolutely. We have our little...
That'd be a heck of a shot,
that's
Jason.
That's a bullet.
Well, that's why you have to...
That is amazing.
Plug holes
and
in
it. And it even has Afghanistan written on there.
Wow.
Wonderful.
Absolutely
Thank
incredible.
You, sir.
Great to see you.